Are you ready to do my favorite ab circuit? I love this core workout. It will really pull everything in nice and tight, but we're also gonna do a lot of transverse movements to create a nice lean waist and create a lot of definition in your abdominal wall. We're also gonna help lean out that lower back so that we're working on a nice, lean, strong core from front to back, taking things in. Okay? Start on your back with your legs extended out in front of you. Lay nice and long, feel that length through your abdominal wall. Bring your hands behind your head and we're gonna crunch first, just getting things warmed up. So get your shoulders up off of the mat and just get a little bit of movement, tighten up through your belly. If you follow me on Instagram, then you've seen a little sample of this workout, but today you're gonna get the real deal, the full core workout. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now bring your knee over your hip, flex or point your toe, doesn't really matter. Reach your arms up and you're gonna move side to side. Nice, big movement. Reach your shoulders up. Work through your obliques. Keep your chest lifted. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now bring your hands behind your head to support your neck, but keep your chest lifted. And you're gonna bring your elbow to your knee, and you're gonna alternate sides. Still try to keep your knee stacked over your hip. So you might not make an elbow to knee connection, and that's okay. Just really reach and move through your obliques and your transverse abdominal muscles. We've got 5 more, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Very nice. Go ahead and take a shuttle body stretch, but just for a quick second, we're switching sides. Tap, tap. Left knee over your hip. Try not to tense your neck up too much. If you're leaning through your core, you'll feel it more in your abs. We take a little break with our neck when we support our head and our hands on the second part of this side. But meanwhile, the stronger your core gets, the less you'll feel it in your neck. So give yourself some time and be patient, and you can always put your hands behind your head if you need to. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Very nice, hands behind your head, side to side. Nice big movement, but stay as stable as you can through your hips. You'll have a little bit of movement, but that's the whole point is you're kind of fighting with stability, trying to stay as stable as you can. Should be burning already. Get those shoulders up one at a time. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Very nice. Extend your legs long. Quick stretch and then go right into your legs off the wall. Go ahead and extend your legs up toward the ceiling. Pretend like you're leaning against the wall and reach toward your toes. Keep your shoulders up high. Again, you can put your hands behind your head if you need the support. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very nice. We're gonna flip over. So you're gonna come into a little cobra, lengthen, stretch out your abdominal wall. Keep your hips level. Push the tops of your feet into the mat, and you're gonna bring your leg up and pulse. 3. Try to keep your hip bones pointing down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and switch sides. This is gonna engage your lower back. It's going to help stretch out your abdominal muscles before we do more ab work. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's gonna work your glutes. Stay in this position and now alternate. So with each movement, you'll feel your abdominal wall lengthen, your lower back's going to engage, your glutes will contract, creating a nice lifted glute actually does help create a leaner lower back as well, but it also gives the illusion of a leaner lower back. It gives you a nice shelf right below it. Five, four, point your toes hard on this one. Three, keep your neck long, try not to look forward. And one, beautiful. Go ahead and flip back over onto your back. Bring your knees over your hips and flex your feet. Keep your neck long, bring your shoulders away from your ears. Now peel your chest up and reach side to side, side crunches. Three, four. Again, keep that chest lifted, and if you need to, bring your hands behind your head and support the weight of your head with your hands. We're doing 10 more on each side. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Very nice. Bring your hands behind your head, in, and switch. Really reach your elbow up toward your knee. Extend that leg. Bicycles here, but try not to curl in a ball like this. You want to keep your knee over your hip. It may come in just an inch or so, but mostly you're trying to meet in the middle. Let's do five more. Five, four, three, two, and one. Beautiful. One quick stretch. All right, now, knees over your hips again. Keep your arms over your head. Nice long stretch, abs in tight. Straighten, bend. Try to keep your spine pressed down into the mat. Three, four. Keep your belly button pulled in toward your spine and your spine pushing into the ground. If you need to, take your hands below your hips and support your lower back. This is a modification that's totally fine. It's still going to work everything. Arms over the head, more challenging. The higher you extend your legs, the less stress you'll put on your lower back. For a greater challenge, extend your legs lower. Five, four, three, two, and one. Beautiful, hug your knees to your chest and bring your hands behind your head. Legs up the wall position. Now straight leg bicycles, lower and switch. Just kind of scissor kicking your legs side to side. You're doing great. Always remember that you can pause the video and take a break if you need to. We're doing 10 more on each side. Really big movement. 9, 8, 7, 6, last 5, 4, finish strong, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Hug your knees into your chest. Reach your arms over your head. We're not done yet. You're gonna roll over onto your side now. You can be on your forearm, tighten your abs, stack one hip over the other. It's really important you keep both hip bones square. You're gonna raise your leg up as high as you can without opening your hip. Lower it down and then bring it forward. Everything stays really stable here. Bring your leg up, bring it forward. If you keep your core tight, your neck long, then you will keep a nice, long and engaged core, which will help you work the right muscles. So you're gonna draw your lower belly in as you extend your leg forward. You're gonna keep it engaged and just open up through your side body as you raise your leg. Up and forward equals one rep. Let's do 10 more. 10. Bring it forward, keep your abs in. You can put your fingers here for stability. You can stack it on your hip or whatever. Float that arm wherever you want. Last 5, 4, point your toe, open up your hip. Now you want your thigh to point as toward the ceiling, as high toward the ceiling as you can. You're gonna bring your leg up and then open up, keeping your hip turned out. Beautiful. And keep that glute flexed. A lot of people don't realize this, but your glutes are part of your core. So keeping your hip adductors and abductors lean, strong, and engaged is gonna help not only benefit your core development, but it's gonna help protect everything, shoulders, knees, ankles, it all works together. Up and back. You should feel the outside of your glutes burning. Almost there. We got five more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Very nice. One more thing on this side. Square up your hips. Bend your knee. Push back until your glute is as engaged as it's going to be, and then pulse. Two, three, four. Keep your abs in, chest lifted. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Squeeze for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Love it. Hug that knee into your chest and swing it around. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Nice and long. Feet flexed. Raise it up. Bring it forward. You can put your hand on your hip if you want, whatever really works for you. This kind of works for me because I can, it's a reminder to keep my hips square and pointing in the same direction for this movement. Abs in, especially every time you bring that leg forward, use that as a reminder to pull it in. Forward and up. Forward and up. We got 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Point your toe. Turn it out. Bring it up. And back, up and back. Finding ways to work your inner and outer thighs without equipment can be challenging, but this is a perfect way to do it. And again, it'll draw into your obliques, and also just keeping your core pulled in and stable helps keep your abs long and lean, and you're basically just training them to stay in and up. Make the movement as small as you need to keep good control while you're doing it. We're here for five more. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Very nice. Square off. Bend your knee. Press it back and pulse. Abs in. Last 10, 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Hug it in. We're going to take, basically sit just in a nice easy cross-legged position, and then just hug your knee into your chest as you wrap your ankle over your opposite thigh. Feel that glute stretch. Sit really tall. You can look from left to right, just lengthening through your neck. And then whenever you're ready, go ahead and switch sides. Stretch that glute, hug your knee into your chest, sit tall. Look over one shoulder and then the other. Nice work, extend your legs out in front of you. We're gonna finish off with just a few more stretches that are also great for shaping your abs. Point your toes, hold it nice and long, inhale. As you exhale, roll up and extend your legs, fold over. With a flat back, just hinge So don't feel like you have to mirror me with it. Now, one last little lower back stretch. Legs extended straight out in front of you. Bring your foot across your opposite thigh. Bring your right palm behind you. Take your left elbow across your right thigh. Just look over your shoulder. Nice final twist. Relieve any pressure in that lower back. Feel free to pause the video and hold this stretch for as long as you'd like. Then whenever you're ready, switch sides. Palm behind you. Elbow to thigh, a little twist. Nice deep breathing. Sit in a nice comfortable position. Roll your shoulders back. Roll them forward. Back once more, tuck your chin to your chest and roll side to side. If you continue to practice back core work, you'll notice results in no time at all. Feel free to reach out to me and let me know if you have any questions. I love talking with you. Nice work.